In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to blur or censor people or objects in your videos using two different motion tracking methods. This may be helpful if you want to publish a video that includes a child but you don't want to show their face, or if you want to censor sensitive information such as a license plate on a vehicle. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along. Let's get started. First, I'm going to show you an easy method to blur the face of a person. In this video, I want to blur the face of this baby playing with his mom. I have VideoStudio opened up under the Edit tab, and I'm going to drag the video of the baby onto the video track on my timeline. Then, with my clip selected, I'll click on the track motion icon from the toolbar. The first thing I'm going to do is drag the red tracker over the boy's face. Then we'll click on Apply Mosaic, and if you click on the arrow beside it, you can adjust the mosaic shape to either rectangle or circle. In this case, I'll select circle. Now I can click and drag the nodes on the preview pane to adjust the size manually to better cover the boy's face with the circle. You can also adjust the mosaic size here by increasing or decreasing the arrows. The lower the mosaic size, the more pixelated the effect will be, and the higher the mosaic size, the blurrier it will become. Now click Track Motion, and this will track the movement of the area we've specified, so the blur will follow the boy's face as he moves. Once tracking is done, click OK. And now, if we press play to preview our video, you'll see how easily we've blurred out the boy's face throughout our video. Now I'm going to teach you a more advanced method of how to blur a license plate using multi-point motion tracking, which you would use to track objects that change in size or angle as they move closer or further from the camera. I have a video of a van on the video track on my timeline. I'll make sure the clip is selected, and then click the track motion icon from the toolbar. Then under tracker type, we'll select Set Multipoint Tracker. And on the preview pane, we'll click and drag the tracker over top of our license plate. Then we can click and drag the nodes to adjust them so they fit exactly over the plate. You'll notice that the multipoint tracker automatically applies a mosaic blur, but you can increase or decrease the size of the mosaic blur as we did in the previous example. Now we're ready to click Track Motion, and make sure to track the entire clip. As I'm tracking the motion of this van, you can see one of the nodes has come off of its original position. So we're going to fix that. All you have to do is drag the scrubber back or click on the previous frame button until you find the point where the nodes begin to trail off. Then readjust the nodes to get back to the original position and click Track Motion once again. You may have to do this a few times depending on your video clip. Once you're finished tracking, click OK. And now let's preview our video. And you can see we've successfully blurred out our license plate so we can publish this video without worrying about sharing any private information. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along and find other helpful tutorials for VideoStudio.